I mean, we talked about wrestler of the year before the voting, and you know, I thought pretty solid that Moxley would win. I mean, it was Moxley and Roman Reigns, and they finished 1-2, so that's fair. And you know, you take Roman, I mean, look, you take Roman Reigns out of WWE, and their performance is very, very similar with him or without him. You take Moxley out of AEW this year, and it would have been a really tough second half of the year. I mean, he saved their bacon twice.
So here's the argument for that, and I've seen this in a couple places, is, well, Tony could have just put Jericho in that spot, or Tony could have just put Hangman in that spot. What made Moxley so valuable in that spot?
It wouldn't have worked as well. And they were all put on. First of all, Hangman got hurt, so you know, you can't really say that. But no, Hangman wouldn't have worked as good in that situation. And Jericho, he could have put Jericho in there. We don't know how that would have worked, but he chose Moxley. And the fact is that when Rampage ratings went down, he moved Moxley to Rampage, and those ratings went up. Granted, when he stopped featuring Moxley on it, they went back down again. But you know, when he was the pick, and he was very successful, and plus, you know, he had overcome the fact on the the second thing, when Punk beat him, he had to come back from Punk beating him clean to being the guy. And that's a tough situation, because you know, he lost clean on the pay-per-view, and then had to carry the company when Punk got hurt and left, or was whatever happened. You know, Punk tore his tricep and got suspended. And that was a real tough period for the company, because you also, you know, that also took out the Young Bucks and Kenny Omega for several months. So that, you know, I mean, yes, you probably could have put other people in there, but I don't know that they would have been as effective. And perhaps Jericho would have been. I don't think Hangman would have been at that point in time. I mean, later, when he was rebuilt up, but then he got hurt. So then you couldn't do that. So.
Knock, knock, who's there? Ric Flair. Ric Flair who? No, Ric Flair who? I didn't get that one. Knock, knock, who's there? Bailey. Bailey who? Wee Bailey made it home in time to watch SmackDown.
That's not how knock, knock jokes work.
Wee Bailey? What does that mean? She's small?
It's we
barely made it home.
Oh, wow, your Invisalign made you dumb.
Why did the referee's feet smell when he was working? Because he was a doodle.
What?
Because he was a doodle.
His feet smelled because he was a doodle.
Yeah, I don't get it.
What?
See, these are so dumb that they're funny.
Am I high? I drove here. I think I was sober when I got here.
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Brian and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, The Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.